It's my great pleasure to be here in this webinar to talk about our research work. So my name is Xianyang Shi. I'm from College of Chemistry, Chemical Engineering and Biotechnology, Donghua University, Shanghai, China. So today I'm going to talk about the title of Intelligent Dendrimer Metal Nanohybrids from Imaging Guide Enhanced Tumor Therapy. So here's the outline of my talk. I will briefly introduce the background of our research. Then we mainly talk about three topics regarding dendrimer based metal nanohybrids for enhanced tumor therapy. And lastly, I will give the summary of our research. In general, for cancer treatment, there are different modes like surgery, radiation, chemotherapy, immunotherapy, and most of them have their own disadvantages and advantages. So, and for in order to have a better treatment, imaging technology is required to monitor the treatment outcome. And in general, these two processes are separate. Therefore, in order to combine the therapy and diagnosis together, one has to develop nanotechnology. There are many different nanosystems like dendrimers, proteins, micelles, liposomes, that can be incorporated with both imaging and therapeutic components to realize theranostics. So we are focusing on dendrimers because dendrimer has many different advantages, like they have a uniform molecular distribution, they have nano-sized control, they can be, their surface can be functionalized. They also have highly branched interior that can be used to load drugs and nanoparticles. So previously we showed that the dendrimer can be used for targeted chemotherapy and MR imaging, as well as SPECT imaging and radiotherapy. And also for drug delivery applications, dendrimers can be either used to covalent conjugate drugs on their surface or physically entrapped in the hydrophobic interior for drug delivery applications. And for imaging element incorporation, so dendrimer can be used to load gold nanoparticle, can be covalent conjugate with gadolinium chelate, as well as radioisotope. Therefore, CT imaging, MR imaging, and SPECT imaging can be realized. So dendrimer has been considered as ideal platform that can be incorporated with different organic, inorganic components for multimode imaging as well as for combinational therapy. And currently, there are many different approaches to construct theranostic nanoplatforms. Mostly, there are two categories. One is all-in-one. The other one is one-for-all. For the former, and so here you have to find an ideal carrier system. You can simultaneously load with multiple therapeutic as well as imaging components. So this approach is versatile, but the structure is quite complicated. And also it's effective, but the reproducibility is quite low. So it is very difficult for translational medicine applications. So therefore people start to consider to develop one for all nanoplatforms. So in this case, they always have a single or simple components. They have very good reproducibility because they have very simple components. And it's easy to translate for medical use. The difficulty is how to regulate their structure and to combine both therapeutic as well as imaging capability. So this is the issue we are currently we are developing to solve the problem. And for tumor delivery, the nanotechnology always need to consider the tumor microenvironment, which is quite complicated because the tumor microenvironment have abnormal tumor vessel, have obstruction of lymph, fatigue reflux, they have uneven blood supply, et cetera, et cetera. So therefore, it's difficult for nanoparticles to penetrate and retain in the tumor site. So in order to enhance the tumor therapy, one has to consider both approach. One is a systemic enhanced therapy. The other one is a localized enhanced therapy. For the first one, one always have to combine with different drug combinations, multi-drug delivery, and tumor microenvironment priming approaches. This is for the systemic enhanced therapy. And for the localized, for the local enhanced therapy, like radiotherapy, ultrasound, or hypersemia, this, all of these approaches can be used for localized local enhanced therapeutic applications. And here in my talk, I will mainly cover actually three stories. One story is like a pyridine functionalized generation 5 polyamidoamine dendrimers complex with copper 2 and generation 3 phosphorus dendrimer copper 2 complex, as well as hypoxia targeted generation 5 meppamidine dendrimer entrapped with gold nanoparticle complex with gadolinium 3. So we are trying to solve the first one is the radiotherapy enhanced chemotherapy and ultrasound target microbubble destruction enhanced chemotherapy, as well as radiotherapy sensitization through the entrapped gold nanoparticles. And here I will talk about the first work. So we are developing permanent dendrimer coordinated copper 2 complex. So in this research, we first synthesize the complex. We start with generation 5 amine terminated permanent dendrimer. We conjugate with pyridine, and then the remaining amine surface of the dendrimer can be acetylated to neutralize the positive charge. After that, we coordinate with the copper 2 ions. So this we form this complex. So this complex, you have the copper pyridine complex that can be used for chemotherapy as well as MR imaging. And because of the copper as a heavy metal, we can also apply radiotherapy. Through the radiotherapy, we are trying to enhance the chemotherapy effect as well as the MR imaging diagnosis effect. And here are the characterization data of the complex. We show that each permanent dendrimer can be used to conjugate around 30 pyridine moiety, and in this case, 77 acetamides, and for the control materials without pyridine, we have 108 acetamide group. And we did the titration. We show that the G5 dendrimer pyridine complex have a very nice, very much better copper to complexation capability than the one without pyridine moiety. And then we use UVB spectroscopy. We can characterize the materials. We show the complex is pretty stable. They have a mean hydrodynamic size around 153 nanometer. They have a slightly positive surface potential of 8.5 millivolts. And we check through the cell viability assay, and we show that this dendrimer pyridine copper complex can be used to kill cancer cells. Not only 41 cells, but also several different cancer cell lines. And we show that the materials can introduce the apoptosis of the cancer cells through the first through the reactive oxygen species generation, as well as through the cell cycle S-phase arrest. And the apoptosis can be further confirmed through the molecular biology studies, where you can see the P53, the Bex, the P10 can be upregulated, but the BCL2 can be downregulated. And we checked the analysis of the intracellular uptake and oxidative stress, and we saw that the copper dendrimer polyplex, the dendrimer pyridine copper complex have a better copper uptake in the cells. And this can lead to the increase of GSHPX and MDA, the lipid peroxidation enzyme upregulation, and the SOD enzyme downregulation. So this means that our materials can introduce the intracellular oxidative stress. And we also checked, really, we saw that our pyridine dendrimer copper complex have actually just copper, copper two, not other copper valency. And we saw that this complex have a nice R1 reactivity, is comparable to the free copper ions. So this means that the complex, the dendrimer pyridine copper complex can be used for T1 with MR imaging applications. So we did intravenous injection of the tumor model, and we show that our materials can actually be used for MR imaging contrast enhancement of the tumor region, where if you apply the radiotherapy, the MR imaging capability can be further enhanced. Through the biodistribution studies, we show that the materials can be accumulated in the tumor region through the enhanced permeability and retention effect. And also the materials can be cleared through the reticular and the cellular system, and they have a good biosafety. And we checked with other the free copper ions as well as the pyridine copper complex. We show that all of these two materials do not have the comparable MR imaging capability than the dendrimer pyridine copper complex. And we did the in vivo anti-tumor efficacy experiment, and we saw that after the treatment, all of the complex do not generate too much tumor mice body weight change. So, and also we confirmed through the HE staining of the heart, liver, spleen, lung, and kidney, and we show that this copper complex do not have a systemic toxicity. And we show that after the combination of radiotherapy as well as the dendrimer pyridine copper II induced chemotherapy, the tumor can be significantly inhibited. And this can be further confirmed through the tumor size change as well as the tumor weight measurements. And the tumor inhibition efficacy can be further confirmed through HE staining and tunnel staining to confirm the tumor region necrosis and apoptosis. And we also established a kind of blood vessel metastatic model, and we show that our materials can be used for this blood vessel metastatic model MR imaging much better than the commercial product of MagnaVest. And we show that through the radiotherapy combination with chemotherapy, the materials can be used to treat this blood vessel metastasis model. So the mice have a good survival rate. So for the first part, we can conclude that the dendrimer-based copper pyridine complex can be used for radiotherapy, enhanced MR imaging, and chemotherapy. So this formulation just have dendrimer copper II as well as the pyridine. So we can consider that this the composition or component of this platform is pretty simple. And so in order to further to promote the translational medicine applications, we always think that because PEMM dendrimer always have some molecular defects like missing arms, molecular loops, trillion generation, and dimers. So therefore, we think that we can use phosphorus dendrimer, which have exact structure, fine structure. There's no molecular defects to replace this PEMM dendrimer copper complex. So here, we collaborate with our partner from CNRS, France, Professor Jean-Pierre Mahara. So they provide us with the generation three phosphorus copper complex. We're trying to use this as a platform for ultrasound enhanced MR imaging and chemotherapy of tumors. See, here we characterize the complex. We saw that there's no free copper ion in the solution. So the copper complex has a hydrodynamic size around 220 nanometer, has a slightly positive charge surface potential. And in vitro cytotoxicity assay shows that the copper complex have better therapeutic efficacy than the free copper ions. Once you apply it with UTMT technology, the therapeutic efficacy of the copper complex can be further enhanced. So here we can show the IC50 of the copper components. See here, you have once you have UTMT applied, the IC50 value will be much more decreased. So this means that through the UTMD technology, the materials can be better uptaken by the cancer cells to introduce the cellular death. So the mechanism is like we check from the BECs, the BCL2, as well as ATP level. We show that the BECs and ATP level, the BCL2 and ATP level both are downregulated, but the BECs is upregulate. So this can introduce the cancer cell apoptosis. And we also show that because of the 1G3 copper complex have a comparable R1 reactivity to free copper ions. And so this means that the materials can be used for T1 with MR imaging applications. And we also show that the materials has no hemolysis effect, so which means that they are pretty hemocompatible, can be readily used for in vivo biomedical applications. So we did the in vivo MR imaging studies. We established a xenograft tumor model, and we did an intravenous injection. We saw that at 60 minutes post-injection, the materials can be used for enhanced MR imaging of tumors. But if you apply the UTMD, and the materials have a better MR imaging contrast enhancement. So this means that through the UTMD application, there are more materials can be uptaken in the tumor site. This can be confirmed through the biodistribution of copper ion element studies. So this means that through the UTMD application, the localized treatment mode, the materials can have a better MR imaging capability. And we did the in vivo anti-tumor experiments. We show that so under the UTMD condition, our copper complex can be used to inhibit the tumor growth with much more enhanced tumor inhibition efficacy than the one without the UTMD, or then just use the UTMD first, okay, single UTMD. And so this tumor inhibition efficacy can be further confirmed through HE staining as well as tunnel staining to confirm the tumor necrosis as well as apoptosis. And we also did the ultrasound imaging, and we saw that this group, the 1G3 copper plus UTMD, can have much better, much higher blood perfusion. So this means that you have more oxygen in the tumor region, therefore can sensitize the tumor chemotherapy of the complex. And we also checked the molecular mechanism, and we saw that our materials promote the BECs, the P53 and P10 upregulation and BCL2 downregulation. So here you can see the BECs BCL2 ratio as well as the P53, P10 quantity value. And we show that our materials can be used for ultrasound enhanced tumor chemotherapy. And lastly, we checked that the in vivo biosafety profile. We saw that the body weight of the tumor mice has no significant change after the treatment, as well as we saw that through the HE staining of the major organs of the mice, we saw that there are no histological change when compared with the PBS control. So this all means that the materials have a good biosafety profiles. And in the second part, we can conclude that we have developed the phosphorus dendrimer-based copper two complex for ultrasound enhanced tumor chemotherapy as well as imaging. And we saw that through the ultrasound target microbubble destruction technology, and the materials can be better used for tumor diagnostics. So we can also consider this copper complex have very simple composition. They just have phosphorus dendrimer and copper ions. And lastly, the third topic, I will talk about dendrimer-based nanosensitizers. So here, we're trying to develop a dendrimer entrapped gold nanoparticle, chelated with gadolinium ions, and in the surface, you can also modify it with natural imidazole, which can target to tumor hypoxia. We are trying to use the gold nanoparticle, not only for CT imaging, but also for a radiotherapy sensitizers. And here are the structure of the materials. I will introduce more how we use these materials for targeted tumor hypoxia, dual mode imaging, and enhanced radiation therapy. And we first use generation 5 PEMM dendrimer. Through the conjugation strategy, we can conjugate with DOTA ligand. Then we inject with the gold nanoparticle, and then we use pegylated natural imidazole to conjugate on the dendrimer surface. After that, we chelate it with gadolinium ions. In the last step, we did acetylation of the dendrimer remaining surface amines to neutralize their positive charge. And here are the characterization data of the materials. Here we show one peg, you have 0.5 natural imidazole. And this one generation 5 dendrimer, you have around 18 DOTA moiety. And for this is the control material without natural imidazole. And you have more or less similar pegylation degrees. And through the UVB spectroscopy, we show that the materials can be successfully loaded with the gold nanoparticle because of the surface plasma band of the gold. And we can also confirm the gold loading degree through the TGA analysis as well as through the EDS mapping. And we can confirm that the gold nanoparticle with a size around 3.2 nanometer with a nice crystalline structure, with FCC, fifth centicubic structure, crystal structure, can be easily loaded within the interior of the PEMM dendrimers. And the materials has a nice colloid stability after they were exposed in PBS buffer, mm-hmm. in water, also in the cell culture medium. They have a nice colloid stability. There's no hydrodynamic size change during the 1 week storage. And also there's no gadolinium leakage. So this means that the materials has good colloid stability as well as chemo stability. And we show that the materials have a nice X-ray attenuation intensity, the OmniPack, which is kind of a iodine-based commercial CT contrast agent. They have a kind of R1 reactivity around 1.3. And then we established a kind of a hypoxic cell culture, and we show that we can prepare the hypoxia resistant CNE cells. It can be named as CNE1H. And these CNE1H cells have a very low oxygen enhancement ratio around 1.1. And we show that the hypoxia cancer cells, non-hypoxia cancer cells, as well as the normal cells, through this test, we show that our materials do not have too much cytotoxicity in the given concentration range. And due to the natural imidazole surface modification, our materials can be used for targeted cellular uptake in the CNE1H cells. In contrast, for this CNE1 cell, it's not hypoxic cancer cells. They have a more or less similar cellular uptake of the gold. And see here, we can see through the TEM imaging, we show that our materials can be endocytosed and especially localized in the lysosome of the CNE1H cells. And we build up this tumor model. We show that the materials can be used for targeted hypoxia tumor CT imaging as well as MR imaging. Especially you can see the control materials without natural imidazole. They have less contrast enhancement than the one with natural imidazole. And we also did the in vivo biodistribution studies. We show that the materials modified with the natural imidazole have a nice hypoxia targeting ability and can be accumulated in the tumor region through the passive EPR-based targeting strategy. And the materials can be actually metabolized with the time post-injection. So this means that the material is quite biocompatible. And we did the sensitized radiotherapy of the hypoxic cancer cells in vitro, and we saw that the oxygen enhancement ratio can be enhanced to 1.24, much higher than the one without gold nanoparticle, okay? And we show that the radio sensitization effect can be produced through the reactive oxygen species production and as well as the G2M phase arrest after the X-ray irradiation. And we did the DNA damage assay, which is a marker of gamma H2AX. We show that after the radiotherapy through the gold nanoparticle enhancement, you have enhanced DNA damage and can prevent DNA repair. So we can also confirm through molecular biology studies to see different marker changes. And we checked the in vivo therapeutic effect of the nanosensitizer. And we saw that our materials can be readily used to inhibit tumor growth. And they do not generate too much body weight change. So this means they are pretty safe. And we did the tunnel staining to show that the materials can be sensitized radiotherapy. The materials has better, have a much more apoptotic tumor cells. They have a much less proliferation, okay? And the VEGF as well as the HIFA have a down regulation. So all this can confirm the radio sensitized the therapy of tumors through our developed nano platforms. And we checked through the HE staining of the major organs of mice, as well as blood OT and blood routines. And we saw that the material has a very good biosafety profiles. So we can conclude from the third part of our work. So we can develop the dendrimer entrapped gold nanoparticle modified with the gadolinium, as well as the natural imidazole for dual mode targeted CTMR imaging of hypoxia, as well as for sensitized radiotherapy. So most of the work has been done by my PhD student Yu Fan, and here we are. We can summarize our work so we can use low dose of radiotherapy, and we can use the ultrasound, target microbubble destruction. We can use the hypoxia targeting strategy to deal with the tumor theranostics to enhance not only the therapeutic effect, but also the imaging diagnosis sensitivity. Okay, so in all of the cases, our developed NAD platform, we can consider they have a very simple composition, which is very beneficial for future translational medicine applications. And lastly, I would like to thank all my group members and my international collaboration partners, as well as the funding agencies. Thank you very much for your attention.